Sunny shores, vineyards aplenty, and the Art Deco capital of the world. We're here in Napier in Hawke's Bay, New Zealand. With over 30 vineyards, the region is famous for its variety of wines. It also has one of the biggest concentrations of preserved jazz-era buildings in the world. It's another side of New Zealand with its own distinct sights, sounds, flavors, and history. We're here for a taste of Hawke's Bay at its finest. As editor-in-chief of Metro Society, I get to wear many hats when we're creating the best stories for our readers. Sometimes I'm a producer, I get to write, I strategize, and I attend events. But the best part of my job is I get to travel. The job really gets crazy, but it takes me to amazing places and introduces me to interesting people all over the world. We made this show so we can take you along with us on my journeys. See for yourself what it's like to be in my shoes. I'm Raul Manzano of Metro Society, and this is EIC On The Move. For my first look at Napier's classic jazz era buildings, I need not look further than our hotel. The Art Deco Masonic Hotel is at the heart of Napier's Central Business District. First opened in 1863, the original hotel was destroyed in a massive 1931 earthquake. The new structure rose a year later, built in the decade's Art Deco style, still preserved here with its classic symmetrical structure and its brick and green color palette. I'm billeted at the Art Deco Masonic Hotel in downtown Napier, where I booked the Art Deco apartment for myself. I've heard so many great reviews about it. Let's see how grand it is. Wow, I have a corridor. This is a portent of good things to come. I'm going to start my room review with this room beside me. This must be the guest room. Look at that, red animal print headboards, plush blankets. If this is just the guest room, I can imagine what the other rooms are going to look like. Come, follow me. Oh my God. Even though the space is small, they've compartmentalized each part of the bathroom. This is the shower with subway tiles, very 1920s. Amazing. A Victorian bathtub with four stainless steel legs. Usually, bathrooms have the bathtubs embedded on the floor. I feel like a royal in this bathroom. I wonder where this door leads to. Oh my goodness, it's a secret passageway to my veranda. And now I'm the toilet and the wash basin area of the bathroom. And my goodness, Molton Brown, very high-end English brand. This is just the guest room and the guest bathroom. I can imagine what the master bedroom will look like. This is the master bedroom. Look at the play of colors between the red wallpaper and the green headboard. I feel like I'm in a Wes Anderson set. Look at the mirrored side tables, the elephant in the pillowcases, the soft bed. Incredible, so plush. I feel like a king here. This is my ensuite bathroom. Look at it, it's still very 1920s. Subway tiles and the Molton Brown amenities. It's incredible. Oh my God, this is huge. Everything is very Victorian, modern. Tastefully, tastefully done. I'm going to sit here and just take the whole English vibe in. A cup of tea, please, butler. Possibly some scones and some cuddled butter.
And it's the Queen, oh my goodness, with Prince Philip. You think she stayed here? Well, the room or the suite befits a royal. Very modern kitchen, painted in such a way that it's very Victorian. And a proper English table, made of teak. From this vantage point, I can see my proper English garden, a rooftop garden. Come, let's go look at it. Wow, this is the first time I've had a proper English garden on top of a roof. Trimmed trees, flowers in full bloom. What more could you ask for? Except maybe for, butler, can I have my high tea over here? Look what my butler brought me. Not very proper English tea. Tea in a glass. I wonder why. I think I'm just gonna stay out here, enjoy the nippy weather. I'm gonna take it all in and become a proper Englishman.
And after settling in at the hotel, I'm famished and looking forward to what Hawke's Bay has got in store. I'm taking a short walk with tourist and New Zealand's representative, Kylie Hall, for a lovely dinner of farm-to-table treats. Hi, Kylie.
Hi, Ro.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you again.
So where are you taking me tonight?
Well, we're in the beautiful Hawke's Bay, mm-hmm. and we're in the Art Deco township of Napier.
Okay.
So I found us a fantastic little restaurant called Mr. D.
Okay.
We're going to go and have some fantastic food.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
Okay, so what makes the cuisine here in Hawke's Bay different from the other cuisines that we've tried?
It's just a town that's nestled in amongst beautiful valleys and mountains. Mm-hmm. The produce is really fresh.
Okay.
It's very much a wine country. Okay. A lot of passion.
Yes.
About food, mm-hmm. and a lot of innovation. And the restaurant we're going to this evening was formed by two couples from the Hawke's Bay region.
Okay.
Who decided they wanted to have a restaurant,
okay.
with food that they would enjoy.
Mr. D is all about serving fresh, local produce and wine without any fuss or pretentiousness. I ordered the Silver Fern Farms Angus Beef Petit Tender, which is poached in olive oil and served with a side of furikake miso croquettes. Kylie, on the other hand, decided on some risotto with braised duck, wilted spinach, currants, and pine nuts. Mr. D also serves artisanal donuts and cocktail syringes. Kylie and I tried the cinnamon sugar donut. We also got to taste the syringes with Hennessy cognac custard, stolen dark rum and chocolate, and 42 Below Manuka honey vodka jelly.